Welcome to a lesson on using Microsoft Teams with JAWS for Windows version 2021. Today's lesson is going to be on using chat. So let's check out where I am. Insert T.
Title is Elizabeth and Rachel Microsoft Teams.
It tells me that I'm in Microsoft Teams and I'm in a chat with Elizabeth and Rachel. So let's take a look around the screen here. I'm going to use Control F6 to toggle through different parts of the screen.
Control F6, search in new chat, combo box, look for messages, files, and more, or type slash for a list of commands, edit combo, suggestions updated, use down arrow to select, left brace 0, right brace 1 of left brace 1, right brace.
And remember, at any point, I can always hit Control to silence JAWS. I'll press Control F6 again.
Control F6, chat list preview, recent chats open, suggestions updated, use down arrow to select, left brace 0, right brace 1 of left brace 1, right brace.
All right, Control F6.
Control F6, message list, Matt Ater.
Control F6.
Control F6, type a new message, editing edit.
Okay, that's an edit box where I can type a message. Control F6.
Control F6, search in new chat, combo box, look for message.
And I'm back at the top. I pressed Control to silence JAWS. I will press Control F6 again.
Control F6, chat list preview. Recent chats open, suggestions updated, use down arrow to select, left brace 0, right brace 1 of left brace 1, right brace.
All right, and it put me back in the list of chats. If I arrow up, nothing. And I'll read current line.
Recent chats open selected.
And it's on recent chats open selected. So I'm going to arrow down.
Group chat, Elizabeth and Rachel. Last message from Elizabeth. Great job. Lots of wonderful info. Should definitely repurpose. Slightly smiling face. On 10/22. Press space for more options as pop-up 1 of 5.
Very good. So gave me a lot of information. Named the chat. It told me that 2 people were included in the chat. It told me I could use the space bar to bring up a pop-up. And I am on it right now. So let's go ahead and press the space bar and see what that looks like.
Space list with 7 items. Pop out chat. 1 of 7.
Allows me to pop the chat out into a separate window.
Mark is unread. 2 of 7.
Good. Mark it as unread. I'm just pressing the down arrow key.
Pin. 3 of 7.
Pin means I'm going to mark it to be at the top of my list. Assuming I have multiple items, I can have more than one thing basically docked at the top of the chat list.
Mute. 4 of 7.
Mute the conversation.
.st0 left brace opacity .74 right brace hide. 5 of 7.
All right. That one has an interesting title, but it's the hide command.
Manage apps. 6 of 7.
All right. Sounds like most of the things I needed were at the top. So I'm going to press escape.
Escape. Chat list. Chat list preview. Group chat. Elizabeth and Rachel. Last message from Elizabeth. Great job. Lots of wonderful.
And I'll press Control to silence JAWS. If I press the enter key on this chat.
Enter. Type a new message. Editing edit.
It took my focus to the edit box for that specific chat, and I'll just type in thanks.
Thanks. Enter. Sending ..
I press the enter key.
Message sent.
And it told me that the message sent. Pretty straightforward. You can arrow up and down through your different chats. Control F6 moves you around the screen. Think of those as regions, and Control Shift F6 will move you back to the other direction. So it's cycle one direction or cycle the other. And Control 2 would put you back in your chats list. I'll go ahead and press that.
Control 2, chat list preview, group chat, Elizabeth and Rachel, last message from you, thanks.
And you heard that I wrote thanks. I press Control to silence JAWS. I'll arrow down to see what my other chats are.
Level 1, chat, Elizabeth Whitaker, offline, last message from you, hello there, on 10/22.
All right, very good. So she said hello there. It did tell me that she's offline, but let's say I want to go ahead and send her a message. I'll press enter on that.
Enter. Elizabeth Whitaker, type a new message, editing edit.
And you could see it changed the title of my window to her name. And if I press insert T.
Title is Elizabeth Whitaker, Microsoft Teams.
It reads the title of the window as being in whichever chat I am in. So I'm going to say talk to you tomorrow.
Talk to you on Tuesday, period. Enter. Sending .. Message sent.
Now, if I press the shift tab key, I will see the list of the different chats.
Message list. Message from Matt Ater. Talk to you on Tuesday. Sent today at 5:30 p.m. Scene. Press enter to explore message content. Then use escape to shift focus back to the message.
So I can actually do things with a specific chat by pressing the enter key. I'll arrow up.
Message from Matt Ater. Hello there. Sent on 22, 2020, 12:56 p.m. Scene. Press enter to explore message.
I'll press up again.
The message from Elizabeth Whitaker, sent on October 22, 2020, 11:17 a.m. The message has an attachment. Scene, press enter to explore message content. Then use escape to shift focus back to the message.
Ah, so she sent me an attachment. If I press the enter key on this, I can actually get to the attachment.
Enter, menu, like, 1 of 6.
Now it said like 1 of 6. So these are the different reactions. Most of you know these from using your iPhone and other devices where you can actually like a message. I'll press tab now that I've entered into the message.
More options. Use left and right arrow keys to navigate. Use tab key to navigate to the attachments button.
I'll press tab again.
Leaving menus. Message list by Elizabeth Whitaker. Toolbar with 2 buttons. Press enter to enter toolbar file attachment using PowerPoint with JAWS APH presentation.pptx. Press tab for more options. Press enter or space.
All right. So this, I press control to silence JAWS. This is actually the name of the file. And it told me it's a PowerPoint and some other information. If I press tab one more time.
More attachment options. Hit enter or space to activate button menu.
Ah, that's what I want. I'm going to go ahead and press the enter key.
Enter. Menu. Edit in Teams. 1 of 5.
I have the options to edit it in Teams.
Open a desktop app, 2 of 5.
Or open in the desktop app. There's some other options in here, but open in desktop app is what I want. If I press enter on this now, it will open the program that this file is associated to and let me work within that file. And then anybody else who's also using that file will be notified that I'm working in that file at the same time. If I save the file at the completion of that and close the programs such as PowerPoint or Word or Excel, then it's going to send that file back upload into Teams so that if Elizabeth wanted to see my changes, she could go in and see that. I'll go ahead and press escape to leave this menu.
Escape, leaving menus, message list by Elizabeth Whitaker, toolbar with 2 buttons, press enter to enter toolbar file attachment using PowerPoint with JAWS APH presentation.pptx, press tab for more options, press enter or space.
And I'll press escape to go ahead and exit out of this specific chat.
Escape, message from Elizabeth Whitaker, sent on October.
And now I'm back in the chat list, and if I arrow up.
Message from Elizabeth Whitaker. Hi, Matt. Just testing this dot dot sent on October 22, 2020, 11:15 a.m. Scene, press enter to explore message content, then use escape to shift focus back to the message.
I'll hit control to silence JAWS. Now, if there was a link, same process would take place, except instead of tabbing to the button that allowed me to open the file, I can press enter on the link, and that would open the browser, whatever my default browser is with that link open. Let's take a look at some other ways to do chat. If I press the tab key now.
Type a new message, editing edit.
I'm back in, and if I press the insert T.
Title is Elizabeth Whitaker, Microsoft Teams.
It tells me I'm still chatting with Elizabeth. If I hit the tab key.
Menu, actions, menu, format. Press enter to expand compose box and format your message. Press right arrow for more options.
And so this is traditional formatting. So if I wanted to format the document with, you know, bold or italic or change the font size, things of that nature, I can do that there. Press the right arrow.
Set delivery options. Press enter key to activate and left or right arrow.
It's pretty self-explanatory. You can set the time and date of when I want that message to go out.
Attach. Use left and right arrow keys to navigate button.
I can choose to attach a file. And when you choose to attach a file, I'll go ahead and try this. Press enter.
Enter. OneDrive. 1 of 2.
By default, it says OneDrive, arrow down.
Upload from my computer, 2 of 2.
And upload from my computer. And this is going to bring up a traditional open dialog where I can choose the file. I'll press escape.
Escape, actions menu, attach, use left and right arrow keys to map.
And I'll press the right arrow.
Choose an emoji, press enter key to activate and left.
The rest of these things are things like emojis, GIFs, and things of that nature. If I press the tab key.
Send button.
I have a send button. By default, if I type in that edit box and press enter, it hits the send button at that time.
Leaving menus, back button.
Now, what are some other ways I can chat? I'm going to press control 2 to go back to my list of chats.
Control 2, chat list preview, chat, Elizabeth Whitaker, offline, last message from you, hello.
And let's say I pressed control there to silence JAWS. If I wanted to, I could do a control E, which will put me in the search dialog or search box, edit box across the top of the Teams screen.
Control E, search in new chat, combo box, look for messages, files, and more, or type slash for a list of commands, edit combo, suggestions updated, use down.
I'll press control to silence JAWS. If I type a at sign right now.
At, combo box, edit combo, at, suggest.
And then I can type Rachel, R-A.
But no, Matt, but Ratch, Rach, but Ratch, Rach, but Rachel, Rachel Buchanan, suggestions updated, use down arrow to select, left for Rachel, enter, type a message, edit.
So I pressed enter after typing her name in, and it went ahead and populated it, and then told me to go ahead and type in my message. And I'll just say,
hello, there, Enter slash it mention executed sending your message dot 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 enter the view in chat button.
And I just sent the message to Rachel. So pretty quick and easy. At any point you can press the control E for edit or search and type in the at sign followed by a person's name, and it will send a message to that person if you type in the message. So it's at sign name, press enter. If it pulls it from the autofill, then once you've pressed enter, then you can go ahead and type in a message, press enter again, and it will send the message. Another way is control N for new message.
Control N to edit, enter name, email, group or tag.
And I'll go ahead and type in Rachel.
Rachel Buchanan, Rachel.Buchanan.
Press enter.
Rachel, enter. Use left key to access previous chat recipient. To start the chat, press enter. Loading more messages.
If I want to add Elizabeth to this.
Elizabeth Whitaker, Uitaker. Eli, enter. Use left key to access previous chat recipient. To start the chat, press enter. Loading more messages.
So I've now added, I pressed enter after typed in ELI to add Elizabeth to it. If I arrow left.
Elizabeth Whitaker, use backspace or delete or remove. Use left or right keys for other chat recipients.
Left again.
Rachel Buchanan, use backspace or delete or remove. Use left or right keys for other chat recipients.
And I'll move back to the right.
Elizabeth Whitaker, use backspace or delete or remove. Use left or right keys for other chat recipients.
And right one more time. And press enter to start my chat.
Enter. Type a new message. Editing edit. I type hope you are enjoying Teams. Enter. Sending dot dot dot.
And just like message that, sent. I sent a message off to them. So that's several different ways to use chat. I hope you enjoyed this lesson and look forward to more lessons on Teams.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. Be sure to like the video and subscribe to our channel. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.